All right, Jaden, quick pin tonight. You haven't had a quick pin like that in a while in college, have you?
No, not for a while now, but working on that.
Now, listen, I didn't think you were going to be able to wrestle today. Let's kind of go back to last week against Ohio U, you and Phil Wellington. Pick him up. He goes into the table. You both go into the table. His head hits the floor.
Right.
What happened in that whole exchange?
What happened was he's coming up out of bounds and trying to get away from me, and he goes to cut one way, can't go the way, so he goes back to cut the other way. So as he's going to cut, I can't really show it, but you know how they try to sit and cut at the same time?
Yeah.
When you cut, you don't just cut away and stand straight up. You sit your butt to go. So as he's going, I notice that's coming, he goes to sit, so I start running my legs. Start running, I'm running, and I go to lift. And we go out of bounds, so I can't really change anything about it,
They didn't call a flagrant misconduct, right?
No.
What was called was they DQ'd, he went back and he couldn't finish right after the injury time.
So what happened right after that was he went down, they came in. They first called me for stalling, and then they called me for unnecessary roughness, gave 1 point. And so then everything was clear from there. Nothing happened. There was no call. He gets up, he puts his headgear on, and then Coach Greenlee takes his headgear off. Says, no, you're not wrestling. So then he didn't continue. So then they DQ'd me.
Did you get a chance to talk to him at all?
Oh, no. He didn't even shake hands with the team after. They just told him to leave. So, it's all right. I don't know if I was ready to talk to him or not. I know I was well enough to be able to come out there and watch the duel afterwards, but, I was upset and I was really, ticked off, but, took some time and relaxed and got back on the train, and now I'm back wrestling, Why did you think I wasn't going to be able to wrestle today?
Yeah, because I thought it might have been a flagrant misconduct, what they called it. Nobody made it clear what was called.
No. I just got DQ'd. I'm not
DQ'd?
Sure.
DQ'd? Okay, so he doesn't finish the match after the injury time.
Yeah.
Okay. Phil Wellington, is it a rivalry? He's beaten you before. He's one of the only guys to beat you in college. Is that a rivalry?
No, not really. It's just wrestling. I don't consider him a rival. I consider him a great competitor. I don't mean no disrespect in saying that he's not a rival. It's just, I just look at it as another guy who's tough and I'm going to have to wrestle. I don't really have a rival, to be honest, with anybody. I got people that I want to beat. I got people that I'm going to have that are going to have good competition. But as for that, I just have great respect and see him as another competitor.
Where do you guys go? What's your next big tournament? Do you go to a holiday tournament? You have the scuffle?
This is actually, Coach Smith hasn't been to see his family in Florida for over 18 years of coaching. So this is the first time in his 18 years of coaching he's going to actually be able to spend Christmas with his family.
So no holiday tournament for you guys?
Nope, just working out. Just
what's next for you guys?
Old Dominion comes in. Hey, Coach Clemson, what time does Old Dominion come in? What date? It's in February. Old Dominion comes in and then...
January. Do you guys come back in January?
Yeah. Because it's Old Dominion and Cornell. So
Old Dominion and Cornell coming for a duel? Buffalo.
Buffalo. Buffalo, Old Dominion, Cornell? Okay, so Buffalo. I don't know. I get on the bus. I go, okay.
You guys have dominated the MAC this year. What do you guys got to do to win the MAC again?
Stay focused. Not be satisfied with the performance that we have right now. We have to look to grow and keep growing. We can't just be like, oh, we're doing good right now and just keep on working at this pace. We have to keep on looking the game. All right? The work we're doing now, it's not going to be enough when it comes to March. So what we're doing now is not going to be enough for the MAC. We're always going to have to continue to push and drive and get better and get better and get better and harder, and smarter. That's what we have to do.
Champ is a freshman, fifth last year. No Kyle Snyder. He's Olympic redshirting.
Right.
First off, we're going to see you in Iowa City. Olympic trials.
I'm not sure. I know, what's his name? Glasses.
I don't know when you say something like
that. On flow. Glasses.
Okay, Christian Piles.
Yes. I already know that he called me caught word that I'm trying to go to 86, so 86 kilo. So, I'm not sure. I haven't really thought about that just because I'm in season right now. I got more important things like school and wrestling.
NCAA title.
Right. So,
Morgan McIntosh, big guy in the way right now. He's the number one ranked guy. Last year, you wrestled in the NCAAs, right?
Right.
He beat you. You take fifth. He takes third. Is that a match you want to see?
I'm going to see it, I feel like, There's no do I want to. It's going to come up eventually. I have faith in myself, and I have faith in Morgan to make that happen. Because I think unless we meet somewhere else, which I'm not sure, unless that happens, I have faith in us both to make sure that match happens, and make it a great match.
What about no Kyle Snyder? Is that something that, what do you think about
it's
that
kind
at all?
Kind of a sour taste in the mouth. People want to say that, I must be happy, and I read stuff like, must be happy and gone, but, I'm not a person. person that when I fail, I just fray away from something. I'm a person that when I fail, I want to embrace it and get back in it, you know? That's something I want to go back and get back in. I want to get back on the mat with them. So, I mean, it's just something I got to do.
All right, man. You got anything else? You got to get on the bus. You got anything else for me?
No, just thank you. Thank you for coming from my point of view. And this is also what I want to say to everybody who thinks that their opinion matters. There's only two points of view that matter to me in this situation. That's mine and it's Phil's. Other than that, you know, I don't really care. That's why I sent him an apology letter, not you.
Thanks for the time, Jay.